The UN quotes that 4 billion people still live in the world without an address today. And what it means is that you can't vote. You can't get electricity delivered to your home. You can't get a bank account in many cases. But if you don't have an address, it's just kind of like you're not on the map. When we actually came up with the solution, it was really great because you just feel like you've got this massively elegant solution to this global problem. I'm Chris Sheldrick, a co-founder of What3Words, which is a global address system. The reason I started thinking about addresses is I actually worked for 10 years in the music business. And what people don't know is that musicians spend a lot of time getting lost anywhere in the world. But a lot of the problems with normal addresses is, to start with, they only cover properties. And actually, there's huge parts of the countryside which haven't even got an address at all. And there's loads of duplicate street names. So like in London, you've got 34 different roads called Victoria Road. And it's mega confusing if you're trying to understand what the user means. I tried getting musicians to use latitude and longitude, but it's just really hard and awkward to use 8 digits of latitude, 8 digits of longitude. So I sat down with a friend of mine who's a mathematician and basically said, how can we take this thing which is mega complicated, but turn it into something ultra simple so that everybody just instantly gets it? So we decided to divide the world into 3 meter by 3 meter squares and then name each square with just 3 words from the dictionary. So by saying something like table, chair, spoon, I'm referring to one point in the world somewhere. We realized there's enough combinations of 3 words that we could name each square in the world with its own unique sequence of 3 words. This system can do so much more than just getting musicians to arrive at their gigs on time. For the 75% of the world for whom addresses don't work, there's actually a stack of far more important applications. The UN are using it to geotag photos in disaster zones so they can get aid to exactly the right place. In Mongolia, the Mongolian Postal Service use it to deliver mail in rural areas, often to people who've never had mail delivered before. And in South Africa, there's a non-profit called Gateway Health who actually give 3-word addresses to pregnant mothers so that when they call for an ambulance to get taken to the hospital, they know exactly where to find them. Even Domino's Pizza use it in the Caribbean because their customers want to get their pizza while it's still hot. We're working to make What3Words a global standard. So wherever you are in the world, if you see the 3 words, you know exactly where that person is. That would be the goal. If you're looking to come up with something which is really going to make a difference in the world, the first part of the design mindset, I think, is to look for other reference points. I think it's crucial to keep yourself susceptible to things you encounter on your everyday life, and then think, how do I apply that to my current problem? Think of the person who first put wheels on a suitcase. It was actually 1979. Now, that wasn't because we didn't have suitcases for a while and we didn't have wheels. Actually, it just required a certain way of thinking to put those two things together, which now feels really obvious. Back then, it wasn't. There are entrenched systems across the world that we use every day, but in most cases, these are pretty outdated and cumbersome. I think if we strip that out and just start with, how can I just put things together to make something really logical, really simple? With that kind of mindset, it's really possible that you can change the world.